Denver Astronomical Society was founded in 1949 as the Denver Telescope Makers Club, changed its name a couple years later, and has been Denver Astronomical Society ever since. It's involved very, very extensively with schools, museums. Some of our members in the past, as students, went on to become astrophysicists and professional astronomers. They took advantage of our scholarship program. They now have professional careers in the world of astronomy and science.
Up there is Mars.
A couple of the major activities that we do at the observatory are our twice weekly public night events and our monthly open houses here at DU's historic Chamberlin Observatory. Clouds are kind of in the way, and our fingers are crossed that the clouds will cooperate a little bit later on and folks are going to be able to enjoy some nice observing of the night sky.
Well, it's fun to come out and just be with the other club members, share what's in the sky with the public. First time that somebody sees Saturn is usually a very memorable time for them. Sometimes they don't believe what they're seeing. It's like, no, you have a picture in the scope. They don't, you know, it's, well, there's the rings, and I never thought I'd see that.
Members are setting up telescopes on the park lawn, and they will be available for the public to come and take a peek through at the objects that are in the night sky tonight, or will be visible. And tonight we have Venus and Jupiter early in the evening. Mars will be visible all this evening for the open house. We've also got a waxing crescent moon that's visible right now. And if the clouds get out of the way, maybe some fun things like Orion's nebula in the constellation of Orion, and a few other things. The telescope inside of Chamberlin Observatory is an Alvin Clark 20-inch refractor telescope. Now, the number 20-inch is not the length of the telescope, that's the width of the objective lens. It's a refractor-style telescope, and it's about 26 feet long. It was installed in the late 1800s and saw first light in 1894, and is still used to this day. The telescope still works. You could almost argue they don't build them like they used to. It used to be used for science, and it still is to a lesser degree today, primarily for education. The University of Denver does hold astronomy classes here at the observatory a couple times a week, and our public night events here at the observatory include observing through that 20-inch telescope if the weather cooperates. The telescope itself, when you see it, it's pretty impressive. It's sitting on about 11 tons of cast iron support, which in turn is sitting on a 320-ton sandstone support underneath the floor that goes down through the middle of the building to the basement into the ground.
It's usually quite a revelation to people who haven't looked through a big scope, what they can see through the scope. And it's also just impressive. People are kind of in awe just walking into this room and seeing this large instrument, you know, tower above them. The observatory was built in the 1800s, and when it was built out here, there was nothing here. There were no houses around. If you see the old pictures, there were no trees. When they initially started to locate the streets, they located them further away so that the vibrations from the horse carriages would not vibrate the telescope. It's still a teaching tool, and the public really enjoys, you know, coming here and seeing an instrument of this vintage and being able to look through it at the sky.
For me, I think it's the fascination with understanding just how vast the cosmos are. So many people have not looked at something like the moon through a telescope, and when they do, they're amazed. And for me, watching the reaction of people looking through a telescope for the first time and seeing something like the moon or Saturn for the first time, whether it's kids or adults, you know, young adults or grandparents, the reactions are all the same when it's that first look. They, in most cases, have never seen anything like that before, and they're amazed. And to me, sharing the joy of the night sky and sometimes the day sky when we're doing solar observing is what I think keeps me interested in doing public outreach. If folks are interested in astronomy, we encourage them to go to our website, denverastro.org, and find out more information about the club. If they're interested in joining, they can do so on our website. We'll look up in the night sky and wonder, gee, what is that up there? And they can come to some of our events, look through a telescope, and have a good understanding of just what that is up there.
stay elevated by subscribing to the city's YouTube page for these stories and more. And stay tuned to our social media channels for more content. Don't miss our new episodes of Elevating Denver, premiering each month. Thanks for watching, Denver.